Hello, everybody, and welcome to this week's segment of Cooperative Health's The Forum. Before we jump in to October's segment, wanted to give a brief recap of some of the projects that took place during the month of September. We implemented Doc Response, Azara, Point of Care Testing, and Google Review Campaign. The overall purpose of these programs is to promote efficiency, patient satisfaction, workforce development, and of course, community development. And we want to give a big shout out and thank you to everybody who played a role in making these projects a success. September was an awesome month, and we had a lot of accomplishments during that month, but it's time for us to bid farewell and look to the future. And with that, we are now introducing October, and yay, it is fall. For those of you who are autumn lovers like myself, I'm sure you are enjoying the nice change in weather and the scenery. There are many national healthcare recognitions for the month of October, and we'd like to spend just a couple minutes to highlight a few and also welcome some of our own team members to talk about some of these national healthcare recognitions, starting with World Mental Health Day, National Dental Hygiene Month, Hispanic Heritage Month, and National Hospital and Health System Pharmacy Week. And here's a full list of national health recognitions for the month of October.
Today, there are more than 60 million people of Hispanic origin living in the United States. Back in 1968, Congress recognized September 15th to October 15th as National Hispanic Heritage Month. Last year alone, Cooperative Health was proud to serve as the medical home for more than 8,000 Hispanic patients. Through our migrant health program, we are able to provide cultural health care services to seasoned agricultural workers in the Midlands. Please join us in celebrating National Hispanic Heritage Month. Bajo cuidado médico se vive mejor.
Hello, my name is Shonda Christie, and I've been with the Cooperative Health for 11 years. I'm currently the clinical practice manager over at Eau Claire Walk-In, and I'm here to talk about me being a survivor, a breast cancer survivor. December the 11th of 2018, I got a call from the Breast Cancer Center, and they said that I had breast cancer. I was devastated. My first reaction was I was crying. I was with my two sons, my youngest and my oldest. And my initial thought was basically that I'm gonna die. Or, you know, just I need to be here for my kids. So at that moment, I just kind of took the news, and it was a little scary and unsure about what I was going to be doing or what I was going to be faced with. But after that, I had a night to rest, and I got up the next morning, and I knew I needed to make a decision, and that decision was whether or not I wanted to live or did I want to die. I wanted to see my kids graduate from high school at least, be here for my family. I felt like I knew I have need. People needed me. I needed me. So at that moment, I made a decision that, you know, I'm going to live and not die. At first, I was scared, and I know it's okay to ask God, you know, why is this happening to me? But then I thought to myself, I said, well, you know, I must be somebody special for God to choose me to go through this journey. So there were times when I was uncertain about what I was going to face, or how bad it was going to be, because at that time, you don't know what to expect. You don't know what's going to go on. You don't know what's going to happen. Didn't know how far along I was. So the unknowing kicked in. But then I stopped and I thought about it, and I said, well, you know, God, because you chose me, then I'm going to take this journey. My faith was built up a lot. I never once thought that I was going to die at that moment. I knew I had to live. My mindset changed because then I knew that every day was like my last day, but not looking to die, but to looking to live again, looking to be with my family and just to enjoy life. Personally, I've overcame a whole lot of fears. Things that I was afraid to do and afraid to walk into, now I'm able to do that, knowing that I am who I am now and I'm accepted just the way that I am. Professionally, now I'm an advocate for the company as well as the patients. The first thing that I would say is, it's okay to cry. It's okay to feel afraid. It's okay to think that the worst is gonna come, but just know that you can get through this. You shall live and not die. And the one thing that I always kept and will always remember is that I had cancer. Cancer did not have me.
Greetings, Cooperative Health family. I'm Gretchen Beckham, the Director of Pharmacy for Cooperative Health. We're excited that we're approaching National Pharmacy Week, October 18th through the 24th, and I invite you to come thank your pharmacy staff and celebrate with us at our four locations: Cooperative Health Pharmacy, Five Points Cooperative Pharmacy, West Columbia Cooperative Pharmacy, and Eastover Cooperative Pharmacy. Come talk to us about our exciting programs, including our free hypertension program, our free multivitamin program, and our SHUG program, which includes our free metformin. We look forward to working and celebrating with you all. Thank you so much for your support.
Hi, my name is Sarita Dixon, and I work at Waverly Women's Health Center, and my position is a lead PSR. So the three components that we like to use for customer service, I like to use four instead of three. I like to use the acronym LAST. LAST stands for Listen, Apologize, Solve, and Thanks. When you use them acronyms, it really helps a patient know that you are willing to be there for them. Listen would be first, because you want to listen to their complaints. Apologize next. Then you want to solve the problem. You want to solve anything that the customer may say was wrong with their visit, whether it can be from the provider to the front staff or to the medical assistant. Then you want to thank them. You want to thank them for still coming into their appointment, and we appreciate their service and we are always here to serve them. Some of the good ways of keeping a positive attitude during a bad day was to keep the company's mission statement at forefront. Cooperative Health mission statement is to provide accessible, high quality, compassionate healthcare in the spirit of the Good Samaritan. To me, that says it all. You always want to remember what you came to work for. We came to work to provide excellent customer service. So no matter if one patient gives you such a hard time, you remember you're here to serve them. You don't know what they're going through, so it is your job not to take that on so personally, and just remember we're here to serve everybody, and let's put a smile on their face as they're coming in and leaving the cooperative. There are times where we do help patients out and go above and beyond. I go above and beyond for all patients, but there was this one incident that really stuck out to me the most was when there was a pregnant patient that came in. She was only 2 weeks that was due and she'd had nothing. She came to the front to check out, was asking what she needed to leave the hospital with, and we explained to her car seats were needed and baby clothes for them to leave, and she expressed that she had nothing. So I took it upon myself to go to Walmart and purchase car seats, and I also had my charge nurse help me out with that, and then I also went to Facebook Market and asked, like, hey, I'm in need of baby clothes. I didn't disclose what it was, who was it in need for, but I just went out there like, hey, I know somebody who is about to deliver, has nothing, and these people were from Guatemala. So she came here, had nothing, so me and Waverly Women's got together and just provided all this baby stuff from donations to purchasing. We got her two car seat swings, a bassinet, baby bags, bottles, just everything to get her home with. And when she called the office to let us know that she had delivered and make her 2 week appointment, me and Carolina went to the hospital and delivered all her baby items to her. She was forever grateful, and I was too, to let her know that us as Cooperative Health did go to help her out with all her baby needs. Promoting great customer service creates a better work environment, because if you are happy, the patient's happy. When the patient is happy, that means you get a great experience all the way around through the office and make it a closure when they come to check out. So if you are smiling and showing them that you are here to serve them, they are going to be happy that they are here for you as well. So remember, if you want others to be happy, show compassion. If you want to be happy, show compassion. Thank you.
Thank you to our Cooperative Health team members for participating in this month's The Forum. We really appreciate your time and great stories. Cooperative Health is home to many talents and resources, and one that I would like to share with you all today is Dr. Mubarak. Dr. Mubarak has been a part of the Cooperative Health family for a little under a year now, and she brings a host of resources and talents to our organization. Dr. Mubarak, by trade, is an infectious disease pediatric provider. As a reminder, Dr. Mubarak is accepting pediatric infectious disease referrals in person or virtually, and she's going to Prisma Richland for consults on newborns with possible congenital infections. If you have any questions for Dr. Mubarak, please feel free to contact her at the information you see on your screen. October marks the beginning of fall, but also flu season. And to help combat flu season, our pharmacy will be sponsoring a pharmacy flu clinic. For more information about our pharmacy flu clinic, please contact our pharmacy department. Also during the month of October, we will be launching our mobile unit primary care services, clinical care management program, Compliatrix, which is our compliance software, as well as phase two of our Google review campaign. That's a wrap of this segment of Cooperative Health The Forum. Thank you everybody for tuning in, and we hope you have a great rest of the month. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and subscribe to our YouTube channel, Cooperative TV.